What's up guys, I'm Preet and you're watching Tech School. I've been using the famous OBS Studio, and when I launched the OBS Studio for the first time, I was having this kind of widescreen problem. So I went on Google to find a fix for it. I found out that many people were having the same exact problem. Also, some of the people were having even a black screen problem. And there were many solutions available for it, but none of them worked for me. So I started digging further and finally came up with a solution. In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix the black screen or widescreen problem on OBS Studio. So let's get started. This problem mainly occurs when you use OBS Studio on laptop, and it's more of a display error. Let me explain why this error occurs. So the laptops, even gaming laptops, are designed in such a way that there are actually two video cards, or you can say graphics card, installed in them. One, you can say power saving video card, and the second one is the high performance video card. In my case, I am having an Acer Aspire R15, which is having an Intel's HD graphics 620 as a power saving video card, and Nvidia's GeForce 940MX as a high performance video card, or you can say graphics card. Most of the laptops, like 99% of the laptops, display is directly connected to the power saving video card in order to reduce the battery consumption. And when the laptop needs more processing power, it automatically activates the high performance graphics card to process the data, and then the data processed from high performance graphics card is sent to the primary graphics card, and then it is actually displayed on the screen. It's a little bit complicated, but it's a fact. So in order to get rid of the black screen or widescreen problem on OBS Studio, go to Start menu, click on Settings, and search for graphics settings. You will find Choose an app to set preference option with a drop-down menu. Select classic app in the drop-down menu, and then you'll be able to see OBS Studio below. If you are not able to see OBS Studio over here, then click on Browse and navigate to the location where you installed OBS. In my case, it is somewhere in C program files. Once you find the OBS64.exe file, open it and click on it. Select Options. Now you will see the graphics specifications. Now I'm not sure which option out of three will be already selected for you, but change it to power saving option and launch OBS Studio. You'll be able to use it perfectly. But know that if you want to record or stream a gameplay, make sure to switch the graphics settings to high performance, because high-end games and software usually runs on high performance graphics card, and OBS Studio is designed in such a way that it only captures games or any software if they are running on the same graphics card as OBS. And that's all for this video. I hope you like it and this solution works for you. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us via comments. Make sure to like, jam that like button, and also share this video. Also subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get notified. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next one.